everybody, and John, if you get here, hello and good morning greetings from Lufkin, Texas. All right, we are empty and headed for Danone in Fort Worth, Texas, which is 204 miles away. Schedule is ASAP. I'll be right back.
Hello.
Thank you. Merry Christmas. Still gotta go and open my trailer, close my trailer doors. I'll be right back. I don't think they'll have a fit. So today is Monday, December 14, 2020. Say a grateful gratitude thank you to Damien Jess, J-E-Z. Damien, thank you for your contribution and generosity on my PayPal. Thank you. All right, let's get going. 203 miles, go! Make a U-turn right here, but as you can see, not allowed. topic I don't really wish to discuss, but for research purposes only, I'd like to ask you guys, for those of you who are tea drinkers, recently I have, for the last month or so, I've been drinking tea heavily. First I was drinking Twinings lemon ginger tea. Love it. But I've noticed that, and I've had no problem with it. I don't think I've had a problem with it. But I noticed that it doesn't have that big of a kick to it. I don't know. This is just my thoughts. But I think the lemon ginger tea does not have that much caffeine in it. So I tried the Twinings Earl Grey hot, just like Jean-Luc Picard drank it. And for this size, I've been using 3 bags and a touch of honey. And it's got a big, it's been keeping me awake. I don't know how much caffeine is in it, if there's even any. But I've been enjoying it, no problem. Problem is, for the last 2 weeks, I think, I didn't put this together, but for the last two and a half weeks, I've been having problems with major constipation. I mean, jiminy crickets. I didn't put the two and two together, but I think that it's the tea Earl Grey that's causing it. Now, again, this is just for research purposes. Does certain tea make you constipated or not? Am I correct in my assumption that it is? I think it has happened, 2 to 3 times now. And it, as I said, I've been experiencing some major oversized loads. Forgive my bluntness, but some major oversized logs. Sorry. And it hurts. It hurts really bad. So again, for those of you who are knowledgeable in teas, please let me know. I'm done. Yeah. I hope you guys are not sitting at a dining table. Yeah. I'm just glad DOT wasn't around. I'd get a major ticket for oversized load. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Wells. I almost said Wells, Nevada. This is Wells, Texas. All right, once again, today is Monday, December 14, 2020. The temperature here is 46 degrees. We are currently traveling on Interstate 69 North, continuing our journey to Fort Worth, Texas, 187 miles. Here. I wish I knew what the name of this town is. Alto. Welcome to Alto, Texas. So if you were to read that in English, it'd be Stop, Texas. Welcome to Stop, Texas. Alto! If you slip, you could always say Balto. Next town up is Rusk, 12 miles. $1.87 for gas. After that is Jacksonville, 25 miles. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the town of Rusk. Population 5,551. We are down to 163 miles to Danone in Fort Worth, Texas. population they have here. 5,000 people. That's not too bad.
Jacksonville.